Hi, everybody. Just a quick announcement. I have a couple of rings that were found in the ladies' restroom. If you happen to be missing them, I'm going to stand down here for a couple of minutes if you'd like to come claim your rings. And we are going to get started in just a few minutes, so happy you're here. Thanks, everyone. Good evening. I'm Beth Cummings, and I'm the Senior Director for Fine Arts for Polk County Public Schools, and it is my privilege to welcome you here tonight. Would you please stand as our 7th and 8th grade band, under the direction of Ms. Lori Baranowski, present the Star-Spangled Banner. That's a great way to start off any evening, isn't it? Well done, folks. Really good job. Proud of you. So that's just a taste of what you're going to hear tonight. Tonight is a celebration. It's a celebration of these students that are on stage, the ones you're going to see in just a little bit, and also you, parents, family, friends. It's a celebration. So we want you to enjoy your night tonight. I want to take just a couple of minutes to do some thank yous. So the first one is to Florida Southern College, and Dr. Margaret Flood is one of the professors here. She's in charge of the Collegiate NAFME group, which is the National Association for Music Education, and they have taken such good care of us today, helping us with lunch, all kinds of different details. And we have a great partnership with Florida Southern College and our friends here in Branscombe Auditorium. Will you help me and thank them? We also want to welcome and thank some of our school administrators. If we have school teachers, school administrators, if you are in the group, would you stand, please, so we can thank you for being here tonight. School teachers and school administrators, please stand so we can thank you. We had a school board meeting today, but we are expecting a couple of our school board members here. Have they made it into the hall yet? If you have, give me a big wave or a shout or a woohoo. Not yet. I think that they're coming in a little while, but we want to thank them for their support. Polk County has long been supported by our superintendent, Mr. Hyde, as well as our school board. And the arts are alive and well in Polk County. We're so proud of the things that go on here. Much of that is thanks to the teachers who every day put in blood, sweat, and tears for your students. So all my teachers, if you're in the house or if you're backstage, and there's a bunch of them back there too, will you step in through the wings so we can thank you properly? They deserve more than that, But that's what we can do tonight, and we do appreciate them. It is my opportunity and my pleasure to introduce to you, he's no stranger to Polk County. He was a former band director. He was a band director at Lake Region High School. He also was a band director and a music coordinator at Polk State College. And I am pleased now that he works with me in our Office of Fine Arts. And he is our senior coordinator for music. Please welcome to the stage, Don West.
Thank you all so much, and good evening. Tonight, you are going to witness education at its finest. Parents, you have entrusted us with teaching your children the knowledge, skills that will help them realize their purpose and their dreams, all those things that you hold for your children. We're dedicated to preparing them for a future we can only imagine. Being a part of the arts teaches us all to listen to each other, work together as a cohesive group, and to become the creative problem solvers of our society. Now we would like to congratulate some of our students for works that they've done throughout the year. For our student musicians, if you were in the All-State bands this year or on All-State ensembles, please stand to be recognized. Many of our students do participate in honor bands such as Allstate throughout the year, but many of them also have been participating in our Polk County, all county bands for several years. And we want to recognize those students by their years of participation. So students, if you have been in the all county bands for at least 3 years, stand. Okay, now, if you've been in for at least 4 years, and at least 5 years, stay standing. Thank you. So that's our 11-12 group. So you see our seniors there, many of which had their first all-county band experience in an ensemble such as this, which you're about to hear, this magnificent 7th and 8th grade ensemble. Tonight's performance will be professionally recorded by our friends at Vista Audio and can be purchased in the lobby. To ensure a great recording, please take time now to put your phones on silent. A reminder that this recording of this concert is under copyright law, so there will be no recording, video, or audio. You are encouraged to take pictures, but not with your flash. And if you feel inclined, you can share them with the Polk County Schools Fine Arts on Facebook. And we will also be posting pictures this evening and probably tomorrow as well. If you have young future musicians who might get restless tonight and begin making noises that doesn't mesh with the music on stage, please take them to the lobby. If you need to leave for any reason other than to take that young listener out, please try to exit between selections. It is our desire that you stay and enjoy the entire concert so that you can see the progression of skills and knowledge that we have been able to hear in the rehearsals. This group that you'll hear tonight had a rehearsal last week, last evening, and then today. And so just in a few short hours, the culmination of their work will be for your enjoyment. To commemorate this evening, Pepware has t-shirts, plaques, and other items for sale in the lobby tonight only. While we do try our best to get the names of the students correct in the program, there may be a mistake. And if so, Pepware will be glad to make a special order if that is an issue. Part of the proceeds from both Pepware and Vista Audio will go to serve our Department of Fine Arts. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you Mrs. Casey Rakes, the band director at Lake Alfred Polytech Academy and the coordinator for our all county bands. Miss Casey Rakes.
Hello, it is my pleasure to introduce our band directors this evening, our clinicians. Our first clinician this evening is Dr. Jeff Kayer. He is the middle school band director at Marshall Middle School in Plant City. Throughout his 29 years of teaching, Dr. Kayer's bands have consistently earned superior ratings at concert and jazz music performance assessments, and he has spent many of his years teaching here in Polk County. A fun fact about Dr. Kayer is that he enjoys restoring classic cars when he is not directing his bands. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Jeff Kayer and the 7th and 8th grade middle school all-county band.
Thank you. wow, what an incredible time I have had back at my home in Polk County. I do a lot of these ensembles, all state, all counties, and I was saying backstage, this has been by far the favorite all county that I have ever done, and these kids are just amazing. Give it up for these kids again. So when you hear all of the negative in the news about everything that the news likes to talk negatively about, I stand up in front of a group like this and I say, our future is bright. These are brilliant children. They are full of emotion. They are funny and talented, like you hear it, so you would believe it. And I just want to take a quick opportunity and thank Beth Cummings, Don West, and Lori Baranowski for the invitation to come work with your students. It has been a thrill. And I could tell you, after working with the directors here, I'm good friends with so many of the middle school directors here, music is alive and well in Polk County. All of the directors that I've helped work behind the scenes, that have been working with the students when I just say, hey, there's a broken saxophone, go fix it. That's one of the cool things about being an all-county clinician, is that I can take credit for this, but this wasn't me. This is all due to the hard work of the middle school band directors and Polk County students. Well, you give it up for your band directors. And of course, the parents, all the money, the time, and effort that you put into keeping your kids in music, it is worth it. We talked a little bit this afternoon about why are we here, and not why are we here at All County, but why are we here involved in music. And the students have really gave me some deep insight of what music means to them, and you have some pretty cool kids. So our final selection tonight is a piece called Flashpoint. And we had a cool experience today. Before lunch, I said, I want you to imagine that the composer was in the room and listening to all of the dynamic contrast and the articulation that you did. Would you be pleased if the composer of this was sitting right here in the room and they played so much better, imagining that the composer was in the room? Well, then we came back from lunch and we played it again with the composer in the room. I'd like you to acknowledge Mr. Tyler Arcari. I believe he's up in the balcony. He is here tonight. So thank you again for this incredible opportunity. I am so blessed. Please enjoy Flashpoint. Thank you.
Jason Aylward is the director of bands and orchestra as well as the professor of trumpet at Southeastern University. Mr. Aylward is active in the music community across the United States, composing for a variety of ensembles and film, appearing in arts festival concerts, and is currently working on his doctorate in trumpet. A fun fact about Mr. Aylward is that he used to be a radio host for NPR. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Aylward and the 9th and 10th grade All-County Concert Band.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you for being here, and thank you for supporting all that's happening this evening and the fine young men and women on this stage behind me. It's just a joy to be here with you. That first piece was not, and then the universe exploded. That was Chandler Wilson's Sunscapes. Chandler Wilson, a fantastic band director and music educator in the state of Florida in his own right. I'm not going to speak to you much this evening. However, in the next tune, we're going to be assaulting some kitchen appliances, so I figured we should know what we're talking about here. The next tune is Michael Colgrass's Old Churches. It features within it aspects of what you can call aleatoric music, or music that has not yet been planned, where students have on their page a list of notes that they could potentially play or rhythms they could potentially play. The other interesting thing about this piece is they've only seen it this morning today. I intentionally did that, and boy, are they going to do a fantastic job with it. I'm excited. It'll be great. The tunes after that will be Olivia Kiefer's And Then the Universe Exploded, a great piece about if you step back and think of what music does when you don't take a close look at it, but think of what it does for you in terms of the broader picture. After that will be Robert Spital's Pachim, a lovely piece that I just can't say enough good things about. And then I feel like we'd be fined if we didn't have a Sousa on this program. So at the end will be my favorite Sousa march, El Capitan.
Thank you.
Dr. Tremon Kaiser is the Associate Director of Bands, Director of Athletic Bands, and Associate Professor of Music at the University of Central Florida. Dr. Kaiser serves on several committees at the national and state level. A fun fact about Dr. Kaiser is that he had such a fun time making music with our students and can't wait for you to hear the final product. Please welcome Dr. Kaiser and the 11th and 12th grade All-County Symphonic Band.
Well, happy evening, everybody. How's everybody doing? Oh, Peachy King. Well, we're glad that you're having a wonderful evening. It's definitely been a pleasure and honor to be able to hang out for the last, 24 hours maybe or so with the wonderful musicians on stage. We have had such a wonderful time. We have laughed together. We have cried together. We have had some philosophical conversations. We've had just a little bit of everything. Just like the other conductors have said this evening, everybody that has performed this evening, they're just so remarkable. And it's amazing how they're all going to be change agents for this world. And them being a change agent for this world begins with them being in performances like this, to where they're able to be around other people that are from different schools, people that might look like them, people that might not look like them. But the biggest thing that they have in common is, one, music, but two, wanting to be a significant positive change agent. So we are extremely excited for what is going to happen to every single musician that has been here on this evening as they matriculate on to either high school or matriculate on to college and even beyond. I know that I've had the distinct pleasure of being able to work with the 11th and 12th graders these past couple days, and it's so amazing to hear some of their aspirations and hear where they're going to school and how they plan on being that significant difference in the world. So from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you for you putting them all in a position to be successful on this stage, and also thank all of the administrators that have been working here time in and time out, those that have invited all of us to be here this evening, but then also, most importantly, the directors that have put them in a position to be successful. So may you please give all of them a round of applause. So just like every other performance, the performance order that we had is not exactly what's in the program. We opened up the program with Omar Thomas's piece, A Mother of a Revolution. Then after that, we went to Kimberly Archer's piece, which Kimberly Archer actually taught here in Florida, in the Bradenton area. And her piece, what's that piece called about puppies? What's the name of that piece? Yes, Let Me Put You to Sleep, or Let Put Something to Sleep. But y'all see the program. Y'all can read it. No, not puppies and putting to sleep, no. So just to give you an idea. No, Kim, Dr. Archer, she rescued a puppy, and the puppy was having a tough time getting readjusted. So she would hum a wonderful lullaby, which is Let Me Put You to Sleep, or what, I don't know the name of it. Just insert whatever I said and just look at the program. But it would always calm the puppy down, and the puppy would just be calm and collected and felt a sense of family and peace after Dr. Archer being with the puppy. So we're gonna just move on to Lord Tullamore, which was the next piece, which is a piece that was written by Carl Whitrock, and it's a bunch of Irish music from Tullamore, and that was a fun piece. And then we're gonna end with a edition of whatever that piece is at the end, because I don't want to say anything that's going to incriminate myself. But my friend Adam Kell, he did the addition of this piece, and so we're just tickled to be able to perform this for you. So God bless, have a wonderful evening, and have fun.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming. Have a wonderful night.